Okay.
Alright.
Why are... Is there any updates to this thread? Why is this thread still fucking here, by the way?
This can't be me, right?
I don't
what is like? What is going on? Is why is this thread?
I'm gonna say that it's Vitality. Yeah, it's Alpha.
Whatever happened to Twitter Gold? Does that even exist?
No. Oh.
Yeah, of course I know. I was like on Vitality Academy at that time, like so hype. We watched the main team.
I need to. 8 year. An so 8 year old account that only has 2.4k comment karma. Okay, this guy is.
It was only last
whatever.
Year. Jesus, it feels like forever.
Okay, next play.
Wait, I look older.
Wow, but Rek'Sai. Okay, this is a long time to
The Rakan crazy. Yeah, the crazy Rakan.
It's the one more combo.
Okay.
Oh, yes,
Wait. Okay, hold on. Well, TF is baby, Ellis is also stupid for like making the situation worse in the first place, right? Kreia's fucked up. Dude, my tweet can't do anything. That's the whole point. My tweet can't do anything, man. Random people can't do anything to TF Blade. The only people that could have done stuff to TF Blade are literally the Korean pro players that engaged with him. My life for Riot Korea. My tweet would have no sway. Okay. Dante wanted to tell us to chill on bringing things to light or pointing things out. TF Blade did blame me, from what I was told. Although I've not seen a clip, so I don't know if it's true because it can just be guy in chat. Even had to talk with Ellis and talked about the situation on the stream. The only thing that Dante's wanted is to stop Ellis from tweeting about the whole situation. Yeah, but we already resolved the tweet situation because it's a misunderstanding on Dante's part. Because he thought that the tweet was something else than it was, but that's fine. A lot of people misunderstood the tweet. Yeah, I mean, this is literally it, no? Trying to blame LS in the situation is fucking absurd. I haven't seen people think that LS is somehow manipulating. That's actually just what's happening here, duh. Trying to contact Riot Korea to get the reasons for bans or to get them. Yeah, I'm just lying about all the communication with Riot Korea and China. And the twisted reason that LS is a psychopath. LS's tweet might only be... So the very first time that this started was when Yamato suggested that I was lying about talking to Riot Korea. But today on stream, Yamato said that's not what's happening. But I just imagine that Yamato was like really tilted. I don't know. Because it was immediately after it all happened, right? But that's where it all started, you know? Dante's take is fucking dumb. Okay, Dante's criticizing Ellis for shedding light. Kids are getting praised. It would have been... Dante's take is fucking dumb because if it was as serious as Ellis portrayed it, it would have been... it within a couple days anyway. Kids are getting praised. Hours. Let's see. Let's say the situation wasn't bad. All the players... They literally aren't blaming Ellis. They just had a true... Lunar didn't watch the whole stream, I'm not defending Blade, but everybody on your crowd, the story makes TF Blade looks 10 times worse. LS was ironically talking more shit and dragged the situation on for hours. You're lying. You're just lying. You're just making shit up on the internet and typing it. What are you doing? I turned my stream on 40 minutes after he was still going off about me. Then I ended my stream. Then he started it back up again, so I started my stream back up again. What are you saying? Read the tweets. He's not blaming Ellis for anything. He just told him not to tweet the drama. That's it. Yeah, but I didn't report them. Ellis. Dude, this guy is in every thread that mentions me. He's permanently on Reddit. I can't focus. Wait, is this the guy that accused me of like a pyramid scheme? Wait. His whole fucking comments is about me.
I should make a fucking OnlyFans, man. Man, these people are obsessed. Like, I don't know what's going on, dude. These are days I can't focus. Oh my god. I can't. Oh my god. Okay. Control. All right, it's fine. Okay, let's see. But dude isn't neurotypical. His expression would be a bit. Dude is almost 30. It's not mental health! It's autism! I can be 60 and I will still be autistic. What are you saying? I can't. Oh my god, I can't. Oh my god. In reality, it sounds like his coaching style didn't work with the players and management. This is not true. Oh my god. Guys, listen. Look, when you can't get a direct answer on something, the best thing that you can do is read between the lines, okay? A lot of people will say that the C9 players or that the C9 coaches had issues with me. All of the C9 players and the C9 coaches they still appear on the fucking co-streams all the time. We literally joke about the C9 incident. We literally laugh with each other that no one knows what happened. I have Revan on my stream all the time. We had Max Waldo on my stream so many times in spring. Fudge is literally I can't focus. It's fine. It's all good. One bad day. It's fine. I can't just say what... Well, technically, I can say what happened, but... I told Fudge that, so I called Fudge, and I had like a 4-hour talk with Fudge. This is a couple of weeks ago. And Fudge told me that I should talk to someone else first before, like, you know, Max told me to just talk about everything. Max says he doesn't care anymore. And just talk, Max doesn't care. Max basically told me that, if I talk about whatever, I talk about whatever, he's so gone from esports, he doesn't care. The whole thing, God, I can't say more yet. My whole life, I was always been someone skeptical of the way Ellis historically expresses how pro play meta should, inability. I suppose Ellis doesn't have to, retort and blast TF Blade on stream. However, TF Blade is one of getting banned and taking the hotel down with him. Okay, we're almost in draft. It's one of those until he didn't stop doubling down when he got harassed by T1 fans. No one piled on. What? Dude, if someone fucking punches you, you can defend yourself. What? Except in South Korea. No self-defense laws. No self-defense laws. Or I believe that there is a self-defense law, but it's like really, really hard to enforce. Anyways, we're in draft. We're in draft. All right, we're good.
This time, though, T1 were like... hard prioritizing.
Yeah, self-defense law in South Korea is really fucking weird. You have the ability to defend yourself only up until whatever would be necessary. What exactly is it? It's like whatever would be necessary to get away from the situation. Anything over that, you're guilty as well. So yeah, basically, imagine this. If someone is punching you and you could get up and run away from them, you must do that. If someone is punching you and you make it to your feet and you could run, but you punch them back first, you're now guilty too. It's like really weird. It's a really weird self-defense law. Does that make sense? You can only defend yourself up until the point where you no longer need to defend yourself.
one could say.
That's why I don't get the Kai'Sa ban.
Like, I read a whole fucking situation on this recently. It was like a fucking Korean lawyer in like one of the R Korea threads that was like talking about it. It's like fucked up.
Like, oh, well, now we don't have Kai'Sa. They could potentially lean towards like the Varus. They could go like Varus
Rakan has to
have. Yeah. There was this guy. Yeah. The Shinlim, the Shinlim stabbings recently. So recently, guys, there's been some problems in Korea where there's been a lot of stabbings. There was a guy literally running up to people and stabbing them. No one is allowed to hurt the guy, tackle him, or anything. If you do that, you're guilty. You get charged with assault. You are to only run. What the fuck? What is going on?
They could also lock in engage support for Carrier.
No, why?
This is also a flex.
Wait, you got burritos? Like
could be playing the Maokai as well.
No, not burrito. Just the fucking same thing as always.
Saw Barrel originally bring it out specifically.
Oh, I know. I didn't eat them. Yeah, I've been so stressed with this shit. So I've been fucking stress eating. Yeah, okay, we'll try it. Alright. Yeah, we'll try it. Fine. Having burritos tonight. If someone starts a shooting, you can't stop him? Well, no. So, basically, Korea bans guns, and you can't get guns in Korea. If someone does show up with a gun in Korea, there's a thing called gongik, which is like public service. Military. Like, military will appear within, like, 5 or 10 minutes. Like, military personnel with, like, machine guns and, like, snipers and shit, and, yeah. So if you manage to have a gun in Korea, military will, like, swarm the place, like, very quickly. Yeah.
Civ is not going to get taken off the card. You could see the Varus
back. Yeah, it's actually like if you have a gun in South Korea, it goes to GTA 5 star like real quick, yeah. D+ have an 8 character. It like instantly becomes 5 star. How do they get there so fast? Because the way that South Korea uses its military for its service is they have lots of troops stationed in every city. They have like they have lots of different troops stationed in every single city every day. Because they have mandatory military. So that's how they get there so fast. So like even right now, the city that I'm in, there is a military office that has troops. And my city, once you go like a kilometer and a half or 2 kilometers, there's another city. And that city has its own military troops. And then you go another kilometer or another 2 kilometers, there's more military troops. So they're everywhere.
And it looks like they might be leaning towards that Mark and the support role. The Poppy, phenomenal value here when everyone on the side of D-plus has a million dashes.
All right. Oh, Corki!
Yeah, that means they flex the Maokai into
Yes! Skarner!
I like Poppy.
Okay. Poppy support versus Rel? Not bad. Not